Sacred Games dropped on Netflix this month and 10 Albanian Lex episodes are available to stream or download in one go on Netflix. The series is based on the critically acclaimed 2006 novel of the same name by Vikram Chandra. Netflix has not officially confirmed the second season of Sacred Games yet, but fans are expecting there to be at least 4 seasons, as season 1 only covers the first quarter of the novel. The official synopsis of the show reads, a policeman, a criminal overlord, a Bollywood film star, politicians, cultists, spies, and terrorists, the lies of the privileged, the famous, the wretched, and the bloodthirsty interweave with cataclysmic consequences amid the chaos of modern-day Mumbai. The 8-episode thriller follows the riveting journey of Sartai Singh, played by Saif Ali Khan, a seasoned, cynical police officer, and Anjali Mathur, Radhika Apte, an intelligence officer, to the center of a mysterious web woven the powerful criminal overlord, Ganesh Gaitand, Nawazuddin Siddiqui. The plot twists and turns along the dark alleys of Mumbai, with Ganesh and Sartai tightening their grip on each other and staking everything on victory, including the city itself. What does Vikram Chandra think about Sacred Games on Netflix? The show's villain is Ganesh Eknath Gaitand, the boss of notorious criminal gang G Company, who confesses to police inspector Sartai Singh of a plot to destroy the city. Sacred Games is set in 2 timelines. One timeline focuses on the present day, following the characters police inspector Sarai Singh and Anjali Mathur as they pursue Ganesh's past to save Mumbai in 25 days before committing suicide. The second timeline is the narrative of Ganesh's past and his rise in the criminal underworld during the 1980s and 90s. Like the book, Ganesh's past is set against the backdrop of the Babri Masjid Mosque demolition of December 1992 and the Bombay riots in December 1992 and 1993, which left 900 people dead. The riots were peaceful protests that turned by violent as Muslims protested against the demolition of the Babri Masjid demolition by Hindu car Savaks in Ayodhya. In reaction to the riots was the Bombay bombings in 1993, which were an act of revenge reportedly coordinated by Dawood Ibrahim, which only further increased tensions between Hindus and Muslims in Bombay. In the Netflix adaptation of Sacred Games, Gaitan participates in a riot for murderous revenge attack against his Muslim enemy, Sulaiman Issa, which helps spark tensions between the two religious groups in the area he lives in. Is Sacred Games a real story? While Ganesh is a fictional character, there has been speculation that he is loosely based on mobster Chhota Rajan. The Hindustan Times described the character of Ganesh as a Chhota Rajan type gangster, and the parallels between Chhota and the fictional character Ganesh are pretty convincing. Chhota was the boss of a major crime organized based in India, who originally started off as a petty criminal from a poor background. He is serving a life imprisonment for murdering a journalist and is also wanted for many criminal cases that included extortion, murder, smuggling and drug trafficking. Ganesh is the head of Gang G Company in Bombay, who also has a rags-to-riches story from a small village to a high figure in Bombay's criminal underworld. What are the 1993 Bombay bombings? Chhota joined the Bada Rajan gang in 1982 and worked for Dawood Ibrahim. They split in 1993 after the Bombay bombings, and Chhota formed his own gang that revolved Dagwood's D Company. There were claims that Chhota reported D Company to the Research and Analysis Wing, RAW, after the 1993 Bombay bombings. Sartai enlists the help of the RAW agent, Anjali Mathur. Ganesh does a similar thing by telling Sartai about a plot to destroy the city. Ganesh's rival, Sulaiman Issa of S Company, is also thought to be based on real-life criminal terrorist Dawood Ibrahim. In 2011, he was named number 3 on the world's 10 most wanted fugitives by the FBI. Sacred Games is on Netflix now.